Cell death is a key process that's necessary even in development in order to get a viable organism. This program is called upon again over and over in almost every disease I can think of, where you either have diseases where there's too little cell death, such as in cancer, or you have diseases where there's too much cell death, such as in strokes or heart attacks. My lab is very interested in the process of cell death, that is, how cells no longer survive. What are the things that cause them to die, and then what are the molecular pathways by which they can die? So if we can determine the pathway by which those cells are being forced to die, we can then prevent that death and maintain the function of those cells. There are multiple different types of death pathways that one could attack. We look at two in particular. One is the intrinsic pathway of apoptosis, which is mediated by a family of genes called BCL-2 family members, one of which we study that's really poorly understood is called BOK, or B-O-K. BOK, unlike all the other BCL-2 family members, which primarily act at the mitochondria, acts at the endoplasmic reticulum, or the ER. BOK is important for ER stress agents, and there are many different diseases which involve ER stress and or invoke it. And tauopathies are one in particular, because in this form of neurodegeneration, there's an overproduction of this protein tau, which then forms oligomers and causes a lot of ER stress. And as the name neurodegeneration implies, the main feature we see is loss of neurons, so death. If we learn exactly how BOK is mediating cell death within these neurons, then perhaps we can find a way to inhibit BOK's action and keep these neurons alive. The second way is the extrinsic pathway of cell death. That's where other cells are from the outside causing the death of the cells. So often in the immune system, T cells are known as killers. They kill other cells, and so they extrinsically cause the death of those other cells. And it was learned that in addition to infected cells, T cells are also killing cancer cells, recognizing cancer antigens that are expressed. But not every cancer has a good antigen and a T cell receptor that recognizes it in order to kill it. And so people have made what they call chimeric antigen receptors, or CAR T cells. And the most successful example already approved is going after B cell leukemias and lymphomas against a molecule called CD19. What we've been very interested in recently is expanding this to beyond these blood cancers to solid tumors. And so we've been going after other targets that are expressed highly on solid tumors and trying to boost the activity of these CAR T cells to kill them. The overall goal of the lab really is the selective therapeutic control of cell death. I'm a physician scientist. I spend 80% of my time running this research laboratory. The other 20% of my time, I'm a hematopathologist, where I'm diagnosing lymphomas, leukemias, and myelomas within patients. And so I'm very familiar with the blood system and how it can produce cancers, but I'm also very familiar with the blood system and how it can be harnessed in order to affect cure.